It's a busy night in the tropics, so they'll start with Hurricane Isidore as of 10 o'clock Central Daylight Time. If you're following the storm and plotting the position along with us, 20.8 north, 89.5 west, that puts the center of the hurricane about 15 miles southeast of Merida, Mexico. Town earlier as Isidore made landfall had wind gusts of 104 miles per hour. Now the official sustained winds are still 105 as Hurricane Isidore moves southwest at 5 miles per hour, and the pressure has risen from an earlier 940 millibars to 950 millibars, or 28.05 inches of mercury. Unfortunately, the last picture here drops out, but you can get the general idea that earlier today there was a west movement, a very vivid eye, then a turn towards the south. West and Isidore made landfall, and now as the center is over land, the eye is filled in, and as long as the center stays over land, weakening will continue. But Isidore is expected to move back over the southwest Gulf of Mexico not too long from now, and as that happens, re-intensification will more than likely take place. Well, hurricane warnings remain posted around the northern edge of the Yucatan Peninsula. Again, we talked about the fact that the center is drifting onto the southwest at a slow pace, but that motion is expected to change gradually over the next 24 hours so that a more westerly track will develop. Then as the center emerges over the warm waters of the Gulf again, a more northwesterly track will develop and possibly off to the north as the week progresses. There is an upper-level low-pressure trough over Texas that could very well come down and pick up Isidore as it moves back into the Gulf of Mexico and swing it up towards the Gulf Coast of the United States. So as we've been telling you all along, you should monitor the situation very closely. And by the way, as Isidore comes out over the open waters again, the forecast takes it up to a 145-mile-per-hour sustained wind hurricane by midweek. So it's something we're going to have to watch very, very closely. In addition, we have Tropical Depression 13, 310 miles east of the Lesser Antilles. TD 13 has top winds of 35 miles per hour, and it is moving briskly to the west, 23. Some signs that this system's becoming better organized, because earlier today, the center was displaced away from the main area of heavy convection, but now the strong thunderstorms in the center becoming more and more co-located, so it's felt that this system, now a tropical depression, will become Tropical Storm Lili. And 72 hours down the road, midweek, as it pushes into the Eastern Caribbean, it could very well become Hurricane Lili, so we'll have to watch this system very closely. In the meantime, tropical storm watches are in effect from Guadeloupe to the Grenadines, including Barbados, meaning that tropical storm conditions may develop within 36 hours. We also have Tropical Storm Kyle in the mid-Atlantic, 890 miles east of Bermuda. This system is nearly stationary, may drift back to the west and actually become a hurricane over the next couple of days. And that's an update on the tropics. We'll be right back after Local on the 8s.
Evening Edition is sponsored by The Home Depot, driving down the cost of home improvement.
Watkins Glen. Road America. Fifth and M. The IS from Lexus. If it handles like a performance car, that's because it is.
Born free as the wind.
Someone else is making meat sauce the same way you make yours, with half a pound of meat. New Ragu Rich and Meaty.
Floors.
Now, what does she know about floors?
I need new floors. Ooh, that's bad.
You'll need my help.
What would you like to know?
Everything.
All right, I'll show you the tools in the tile section.
How's this hold up?
Great.
Want us to install it?
Yeah. Now, you guys install the carpet, I'll do the top.
Hi.
Well, what do you think?
Great.
You're a good kid.
Thanks, Dan. Come on, what do you see in the kitchen?
At Kelly Services, we provide companies with attorneys, engineers, accountants, even scientists. We also provide schools with the very best qualified, screened, and trained substitute teachers. Because without quality teachers, there would be no attorneys, engineers, accountants, or scientists. Kelly Services, look what we do now.
Hurricane Isidore sent hundreds of thousands of residents to shelters along Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula. As the storm struck the coast, it carried 125 mile per hour winds. It dumped 10 to 20 inches of rain that brought flooding. Winds have eased to around 75 miles per hour now as the storm continues to spread inland. But rain will continue to be a big problem, and on top of what's already fallen, 10 to 20 more inches is likely. We'll also see some coastal flooding, probably 4 to 6 feet at least above the tide levels here. We're continuing to watch now Isidore over land push toward the south-southwest very slowly at about 5 miles an hour. Winds in the center of the storm still hurricane force at 75 miles an hour, and the central pressure estimated to be 952 millibars. A closer look here shows that it is, the center is still over land, but eventually it's expected to emerge back out over the water and strengthen even more. Where it goes from there? Hard to say at the moment. It could continue to move westward or maybe even take a turn toward the north, which would affect the United States with probably some rainfall and certainly with some waves. We'll continue to watch the hurricane warnings in effect for now here along the Yucatan Peninsula coast, and also tropical storm warnings all the way back to Veracruz. Elsewhere in the Atlantic, we're watching a couple of more situations here, a tropical storm and a tropical depression toward the south. This is Tropical Storm Kyle, now about 870 miles east of Bermuda. It's basically stationary, winds in the center of about 40 miles an hour, and we'll continue to see probably Kyle to be just a marine hazard, not affecting any land areas. The same may not be true, though, of Tropical Depression 13, just moving into your screen here toward the Lesser Antilles, and it packs winds of 35 miles an hour. It's moving toward the west at a pretty good clip of about 23 miles an hour. Tropical storm watches in effect for the Lesser Antilles, and eventually it is expected to increase to probably a tropical storm or even hurricane strength as it moves toward the west. We will keep an eye on this one, and if it does strengthen tropical storm strength, it will be called Tropical Storm Lili. In the meantime, the Pacific, pretty clear here. Let's check what's happening toward the 48 states here with Cheryl.
The latest weather map does show some fairly active conditions for some of you, with a front pressing towards the northeast, spawning some locally heavy rains this morning for parts of New England. Another weather system, too, developing some showers and storms for the upper plains states. And of course, as Nick was mentioning, we have Hurricane Isidore we're watching very closely around the Yucatan Peninsula, because it has been generating some big seas and big swells. And some of that rough weather and heavy surf is now affecting the Texas shoreline, where we have coastal flood watches and coastal flood warnings in effect, because we've seen some bigger than usual waves. Some of the waves just offshore approaching 8 feet high. Now, along with that, too, we've had some locally heavy rains, too, streaming back towards Texas, primarily this morning running from Corpus Christi and running southward towards McAllen and Brownsville, Texas. In the northeast, our cold front continues to march on through. We have seen some very heavy rains, especially around the Boston metro area this morning. Another weather system, too, developing across Minnesota will bring more rains for the Twin Cities, and some of that rain could be locally heavy for the Western Lakes. Nick?
A damp day for some in the Northeast, plus the changing path of Isidore. Reasons to stay right here for another hour of First Outlook. We'll start at 6:01 with a chance of needing rain gear as you head to work or school in Boston, New York City, and other parts of the Northeast. At 6:04 and in the Tropical Update, the latest information on Isidore's direction. It's something anyone along the Gulf needs to track. At 6:10, the changes cruise lines are making in light of Isidore. Then at 6:40, the whirling column seen off the coast of Florida.
And here's your forecast for Monday in Boston. Kind of wet and stormy. We're expecting temperatures very cool and mild, though, in the lower 70s.
What's stopping you from getting my free computer learning lesson? Hi, I'm John Scherer, CEO and founder of Video Professor. Millions of people have called to try my free computer lesson, but there are millions more who haven't. So let me answer some questions that I get asked every week by people just like you.
Is it really free?
Yes, it's really free. Just call that 800 number on your screen, and I'll send you a $60 lesson of your choice absolutely free. You choose from Windows, Word, Excel, Quicken, or any other title, and all you pay is a small shipping and handling.
So if it's really free, how do you stay in business?
Because I give people a free lesson. They try it, they see how simple and easy it is to learn with, they call us, they order more.
Is it really for anyone?
Absolutely. My lessons are designed to teach anyone quickly and easily, no matter what their skill levels are. You know, just pop the disc in your computer, follow the step-by-step instructions. It's just like using a VCR. You'll be up and running in less than an hour.
What if I'm not happy with my lesson?
Believe me, you will be. Because if this doesn't do everything I say, I'll even refund your shipping and handling. And almost no one in 15 years has asked for their shipping and handling back. And that's because if you're really interested in learning to run a computer...
Isidore dumped inches of rain on the Yucatan Peninsula, forcing hundreds of thousands into shelters to ride out the storm. Go ahead and give you the big picture over the Atlantic Basin and show you where everything is shaping up. We have Isidore at the far edge of your screen here, just to the where you see Florida, southwest there. We also have Tropical Storm Kyle, which is sitting out in the Atlantic Basin. We have Tropical Storm Lili, which is getting closer and closer to the Lesser Antilles. And we also have a disturbance coming off of the African coast. First things first, Tropical Storm Isidore. Winds right now at 65 miles an hour. Its position is 55 miles to the south of Merida, Mexico, and this is the capital of the Yucatan, where about 800,000 people live, and the eye center came very close to it. They're having a lot of problems with communication across the Yucatan Peninsula. Right now it's drifting eastward and the estimated pressure is at 28.35 inches. Currently, Isidore is still over the Yucatan. You can still see it's got pretty good circulation still, but one thing that the National Hurricane Center has noticed is that the core of the winds from the center of circulation has actually collapsed, and a lot of the convection is now pulling away from the center of circulation. The forecast, though, is still expected to take it into the Gulf of Mexico within the next 24 hours. As it does so, it's expected to strengthen once again. The exact path still yet to be determined, but we do have some initial guesses that is going to continue to track towards the north-northwest. We do have tropical storm warnings that are in effect for the Yucatan Peninsula and extending into parts of southern Mexico following along the Bay of Campeche. Here's a look at the visible satellite picture, and you can see that the bands from Isidore still extend out over western Cuba, where we're still seeing some heavy downpours, and these bands almost extend to the Texas Gulf Coast. And because of that, we do have coastal flood watches that are in effect from Bay St. Louis, Mississippi, down towards Baffin Bay, Texas, and then coastal flood warnings in effect from Baffin Bay, Texas, down to Brownsville, Texas. And be on the lookout here for rip currents and also very rough seas. Here's a look at the projected path of Isidore. Of course, we are closely monitoring it. It's got to get back out over water. The exact strength is yet determined to see how well it can reorganize once it gets out over water and how long it sits in the Gulf of Mexico. Still forecasting, though, that northward turn, so anyone with interest, or if you do live between Texas and the Louisiana, Mississippi Gulf Coast, you'll need to really stay on top of the situation over the next several days. As you can see here, we are monitoring it into the Gulf of Mexico through Thursday morning, still out over the open water. Meanwhile, let's take you out into the open Atlantic, where we do have Tropical Storm Kyle. It's about 870 miles to the east of Bermuda. Winds at 40 miles an hour, drifting south-southwest at 6 miles an hour. It's out here on its own and generally is not expected to affect anyone except for shipping interests. Meanwhile, Tropical Depression 13 has now been upgraded, thank you very much, Bob, to Tropical Storm Lili. Lili is moving to the west-northwest at 17 miles an hour, and the sustained winds are currently at 50 miles an hour. Locally heavy rainfall is possible in the Lesser Antilles. As much as 4 to 6 inches of rain is possible. And as we take a look here, we're looking for the possibility of some type of
watch or warning to be put out later today for Grenada. Here's a look at the storm system. Still a lot of convection associated with it. They have already had reports of winds gusting to 55 miles an hour in Barbados associated with the storm system. It's continuing on its westward track, and it'll affect the islands within the next 12 hours. Here's a look at the storm watches that are in effect from Martinique north to Guadeloupe, and tropical storm warnings in effect for Barbados down to further south along the chain. And you can see here that the projected path takes it over the islands into Hispaniola by Thursday morning. Otherwise, it's still very active across parts of the tropics right now. We will keep you abreast across the lower 48, still active in the southeast. Here's Bob.
Yes, we're concerned about waterspouts as we head toward the mid-Atlantic, Pamlico Sound. There had been a waterspout sighted in that general vicinity earlier, and also around Lake Ontario, not far from Rochester, around Irondequoit Bay to Mexico Bay, concerns about waterspouts. We'll be updating on these areas concern.
To keep your business moving in the right direction, you need to make the best decisions about your image. Fast Signs offers sign and graphic solutions to make your choices simple. With locations coast to coast, Fast Signs is ready to keep your business moving. Fast Signs, sign and graphic solutions made simple. Call, click, or visit a Fast Signs location near you.
For a Fast Signs near you, call 800-FAST-SIGNS or visit fastsigns.com.
Hi, I want a dishwasher and I want the best deal.
Well, we match any price.
Hi, if I bought an appliance here and saw it for less, then what?
Bring us the receipt within 30 days and we'll give you the difference.
Excuse me?
Yes, we price match.
I'll take it.
You got a little...
Where can you get the top six brands of appliances, including Kenmore? Where can you get great credit options and a price match guarantee? Sears. Where else?
You look great.
Thank you.
Oh, you know what? It's your birthday. It's all taken care of.
All right. Here you go. Enjoy.
30 shrimp for your 30th birthday.
I'm 29.
20 miles an hour and gust of 104 miles an hour. Homes have been damaged and trees are toppled. Much of Mérida, the capital city, was left without power. Hi, and welcome to the Tropical Update. I'm Christina Abernathy. Isidore is now one of three systems we're watching. And for the latest, let's go to our hurricane expert, Dr. Steve Lyons.
Thanks, Christina. And it's a rainy night in the Yucatan and western Cuba. And it's a blustery night in the southern Antilles with another tropical storm making landfall and moving through that area. Let's look at the large-scale picture, and I'll show you where these features are that we're interested in. Isidore, of course, is over the Yucatan and weakening as we speak. Lily, on the other hand, is strengthening and moving through the southern islands, and this is expected to become a hurricane over the next 48 hours as it moves south of Puerto Rico. And Kyle, a tropical storm and rains far north in the Atlantic and a marine hazard only. Now, Tropical Storm Isidore, winds are down to 50 miles per hour. It's drifting around slightly to the northeast, at least at 4 p.m. Pressure was up to 968 millibars, which is still a pretty low pressure considering it's a tropical storm. Now, the thing we note, first of all, is it was a very sharp spinning top there earlier today, and that sharp spinning top is starting to collapse a little bit, so the circulation is starting to shrink in depth, which is good news. We don't want it to be strong. However, we do expect it to be picked up by this trough of low pressure here, and as it's picked up by the trough of low pressure, we'll come back over the Gulf of Mexico and redevelop, and how fast it develops depends on how strong it is when it comes offshore. But we do expect eventually it to become a hurricane if it moves offshore. There is uncertainty to that track or trajectory because this trough is not all that strong. So we'll monitor that carefully over the next several days, but it'll be heading toward generally toward the northern Gulf of Mexico. Now, Tropical Storm Lily has moved through the islands, or moving through the islands. Barbados had wind gusts to 75 miles per hour earlier. Sustained winds now are 60. The system is moving very fast to the west. This system's going to get out of the way in a hurry. But most of the islands down here have sustained winds of 45 to 50 miles per hour right now, and some blustery weather, circulation center being about right there. So it doesn't look all that impressive on satellite imagery, but packing a very hard punch here with strong winds. It's going to move through the islands toward the northwest over the next 24 to 36 hours and then head on toward the southern portions of the area near Hispaniola, Dominican Republic, and Haiti on Wednesday evening. And as it goes, it should continue to intensify. So we're going to monitor this carefully as it's moving rather quickly toward the west-northwest. Tropical storm watches and warnings are up, and all of these areas in tropical storm warnings are getting tropical storm wind conditions right now. As I mentioned, Barbados there, gusts to 75 miles per hour. Tropical storm Kyle way up in the North Atlantic, not showing any signs of hurting anybody right now unless you're a small vessel in the mid-Atlantic. Christina?
All right, thanks a lot, Dr. Lyons, for that update. Well, across the rest of the U.S., what we're watching is a lot of quiet weather for a lot of people, but we do have some wet weather in Florida and up into the Carolinas as well as the Western Lakes region. As we put it all into motion, you can see the areas that are seeing the rain and thunderstorms. We've even had some severe weather here in Wisconsin, and we're also watching storms in eastern North Carolina and into southern Florida. Some of those rain bands have made it up into Florida, and in the central and southern part of the peninsula, we're seeing wet weather. And, of course, also seeing that here in eastern North Carolina. Head northward, a front has moved off the northeast coast, taking most of the wet weather with it. That's out over the Atlantic. And then back into Wisconsin and now into upper Michigan and northwestern lower Michigan. We're seeing some soggy conditions here and some stormy weather, even isolated severe, not out of the question. And we've also got the potential for stormy weather along the southeast coast and into Florida. Stay with us.
This program was brought to you by Moen Faucet. Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life. The Revolution Massaging Showerhead from Moen. You've never felt water do this before. Create the perfect shower when you get water to spin, twist, and twirl. It will reinvent your whole day. Revolution Massaging Showerhead from Moen. Buy it for looks, buy it for life.
Florida's natural premium orange juice is made just from our fresh oranges, not from concentrate. We own the land, the trees, and the company. Florida's natural. It's as close to the grove as you can get.
She's a gorgeous woman, and I love her through thick and thin.
It's good to know that you have somebody that's there for you no matter what.
Michelle lost the weight for herself. She didn't lose it for me.
The Slim Fast Plan helped me take control of my life. It was just so simple, so easy. It has vitamins, minerals, and it's so delicious.
She feels good about herself, and that sort of radiates to the rest of us.
It's just wonderful. I live life in both bodies, and I just like the view from here.
Slim Fast. It's your life. Feed it right.
Walgreens has thousands of locations across America. From the corner of Elm and Main to the corner of Montgomery and Pine to our newest location, Walgreens.com. You can manage your health care on America's healthiest website because America's favorite corner...